Okay, you want to set up a filament sensor for your extruder. What I've done is I made a model of what I think it should be like. I'm not sure if this is going to be my final version of it, but basically I'm using an optical sensor that I'm securing over here. I'm placing the filament in here so that it passes the sensor. Now keep in mind you have to use a dark filament. If you use a clear filament, this won't work. So what you're going to do to connect this is kind of simple, but kind of not like the directions that they gave you. What you're going to need to do is, because it says to use pin 4 for the servos, you have to place a jumper on these two pins to give it power. It's the VCC and 5 volt. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your jumper. You're going to place it right here, and that's going to power these pins for you. Now the pins are slightly different. It's negative on the bottom, positive in the center, and then your signal pin is on top. So it's different from your actual end stops. So I've marked these. I have red for my 5 volts. I have black for my ground, and then I have my signal pin. So normally they tell you to use pin 4, which would be these pins on the outer edge, but we're going to use the ones 1 over because there seems to be some kind of issue in the pins file. So for black, you're going to put it on the bottom, second in, then you're going to do red, which is your power, and then your signal will be on top. So that's how you connect your actual sensor pin. Now this is going to be a normal stepper configuration. You're going to need to hook up your stepper over here to your stepper 0. And then I ran into another issue with LCD panels. The smart discount LCD panel appears not to work with the filament out, whereas the rep wrap discount full graphics smart controller appears to work quite well. Now you're also going to need to have a SD card that's loaded with a file in G-code format. So this part I'm going to ignore showing you how to set up, because there's great videos out there. One by I believe somebody named Thomas. He explains this quite well. So I'm gonna skip that part, but I'm gonna show you the full configuration as it's set up and how to modify the file in just a second. Okay, we're gonna open up Marlin. Here's the solution file. We're going to go to the configuration.h tab, and we're going to search on LCD, and that's going to bring us to LCD and support. But then I'm going to scroll down and uncomment SD support. We're also going to uncomment SD check and retry. Then we're going to look for the speaker. Here we go. We're going to uncomment the speaker for the LCD panel. And then we're going to uncomment LCD feedback frequency duration. And we're also going to do LCD feedback frequency in hertz. We're then going to go and find the entry for the rep wrap discount full graphics smart controller. So let's see if we can skip to it here.
go. So that's the actual graphics controller we want to use. Now we also want to go find the define filament runout. Okay. Now we want to uncomment filament runout sensor. All of the rest of this we'll leave as default for the moment. And now we want to go to the advanced tab. And we want to go find the advanced pause feature. I want to uncomment this as well. Now there's several settings in here. I'm not going to go over all of them, but as you can see here, the is the advanced pause and a little bit of an explanation of how it works. Now that's all we need to do for the Marlin portion for config.h and then config advanced.h. But we also have to modify pins. So we're going to go back over here. We're going to find pins. And then we're going to scroll down to the ramps.h. We're going to open that up. We're going to search on runout. Now, a possible reason why it might not be working has to do with maybe this fan pin, I'm not sure. But for now, what we're going to do is we're going to cheat because we don't have a filament width sensor to worry about at the moment. So we're going to change that to 4. We're going to change that to pin 5. So normally we would connect to the 4th set of pins, but we're going in one, which is pin 5. And we're going to save that. Then we're going to go back to Marlin, and we're going to upload and compile. So it's first going to compile and upload. Okay, we're going to open up Pronterface, and we're going to connect to the printer. Now the first thing we want to do is verify that our actual sensor is working. So with a dark filament that's not clear inserted in the sensor, we're going to do M119. It says triggered. Now we're going to remove the actual filament and do M119 again. Now it says open. So it appears to work correctly. So the next step is to show you how it works on the actual configuration.
Okay. Got the LCD panel configured and connected. We have the SD card connected. We have our normal configuration over here. And then we have our optical sensor with a dark filament inserted. I'm going to have to turn off the light so you can see this better. Let me zoom in for you. And I'm going to plug it in. Now notice we have 1.1.6 for our Marlin firmware version. We're going to navigate to the SD card. We're going to pick a file. We're going to let it home. It's going to heat up. and we've just thrown the error because the filament is bent, so it's unloading it. And now it's saying insert and press button to continue. So that's the simple process of actually adding the filament back in. Making sure the sensor is tripped. Then you're gonna press continue and it's actually gonna load it. So if you like my video, please press the like button and thank you for your time and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.